Welcome to the .NET MAUI Datetime Picker Control Tutorial. The Syncfusion.NET MAUI Datetime Picker component allows you to select a date and time easily. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add a datetime picker to a .NET MAUI project. I'll also show you how to customize the datetime picker's width and height, programmatically select a date and time, add a footer, customize the text on the validation buttons, and change the date and time format. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application, then give the project name and location. Next, create a project with a .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the datetime picker control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Picker NuGet package, so I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Picker package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. Open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the apps.xaml CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, refer to the instructions provided in the link in the description below. Next, navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI picker namespace. Then, initialize the datetime picker control. Now, let me run the application. Looking here, the datetime picker is displayed. In the header, you can see the current date and time. You can select the date and time separately by switching between the date and time tabs. To customize the UI, I load the datetime picker control inside a border element. Then, set the height request to 400 and width request to 350. As you can see, the control is displayed within a border. To programmatically select a date and time, set the selected date property to an appropriate value. By default, its value is the current date and time. Check here. The specified date and time have been selected. Next, let me show you how to add a footer. To display a footer, define the footer view property. Then, add a picker footer view element. It offers built-in validation buttons such as OK and Cancel. To show these buttons, set the height to 40. Look here, OK and Cancel buttons are displayed at the bottom of the datetime picker. To customize the validation button's text, set the OK button text to Yes and Cancel button text to No. Now, you can see the OK button text changed to Yes and the Cancel button text changed to No. Finally, I will show you how to customize the format of the datetime picker. To customize the date format, set the date format property to date month year. Similarly, to customize the time format, set the time format property to hour minutes. By default, it is set to the hour, minute, second. Check here, the date and time format has changed as specified. In this video, I have demonstrated how to create a .NET MAUI application and incorporate the Syncfusion datetime picker control. I showed you how to customize the datetime picker's width and height, programmatically select a datetime, add a footer, customize the text of the validation buttons, and customize the datetime format. To learn more about datetime picker features, you can check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.